It's the 2016 Skeeter Bass Champs Championship event. Where am I? I'll tell you right now. I'm in Orange, Texas, on the Sabine River. And the word is the fish are biting. We're going to find out exactly how many bass it's going to take to win this thing. Remember, two Skeeter boats will be given away on day two of the championship event. Stay tuned.
In 1997, two friends in North Texas created the Bass Champs Tournament Organization. Chad Potts and Jeff Welch devised an innovative plan to create an online presence along with amateur fishing events that have changed the landscape of competitive bass fishing. In 2002, Skeeter Boats stepped up and joined the team as the title sponsor. And today, the Skeeter Bass Champs Tournament Trail is the largest team tournament circuit in the nation, boasting the richest guaranteed payback in grass roots competition and drawing competitors from all over the country. I'm your host, Fish Fishburne, and this is Bass Champs.
Skeeter Bass Champs with Fish Fishburne is brought to you by
Skeeter, eat, sleep, fish. Yamaha, reliability starts here. Chevron Dello, let's go further. Berkeley, catch more fish. Techron, expect more. Power Pole, swift, silent, secure. Lowrance, find, navigate, dominate. Sportsman's Auto Network, dealers that speak our language.
Skeeter Bass Champs with Fish Fishburne starts now.
Well, it was 5 a.m. when the first boat hit the water this morning, and we're approaching the 7 o'clock hour. That's when they'll let the guys leave the basin. And I gotta tell you something, some of these competitors are running one way 2 hours. So in an 8-hour fishing day, 4 hours or half of your time is burned. But that's okay if you catch those 5 all-important largemouth bass. Now I gotta tell you, the weather is gonna be great today. Variable winds up to 6 or 7 miles an hour, and it's gonna be sunny. So everybody seems like they're excited. There's a lot of anticipation on getting that critical one big bite. Chad, it's the first time that the Skeeter Bass Champs has been to Orange, Texas. Dude, this is a great event.
It is. It's a cool facility. I've never been here either, but it's nice to see. Some guys are having, a lot of guys are having a lot of fun. They're just trying to figure it out. It's such an even playing field that really no one has their home water, so it's kind of interesting to hear the stories that they're having.
We talked about the magnitude of this body of water with all the diversity and all of the different routes and waterways that they can approach. What do you expect? I mean, are we looking for big weights, small weights?
I think a lot of people are catching a lot of fish. They're just not finding the size. I know they're in here, but they're having to dissect a lot of area, and it's so intimidating for the guys that have never been here because it's, when you look at it, like you said, it's just huge. So I think the guys that are just kind of figuring out, hey, I'm just going to target one specific area and figure out how to fish that area, I think that's going to be the guys that end up doing well. But they're all going to catch fish.
Give me a guess on weight for day one.
I think probably 15, 16 pounds will lead day one, and 26, 27 will win.
I think you're close.
We'll see.
We'll watch.
All right, here we go. Official time, 7:06 plus 18 seconds. Boat one, Anglers of the Year from the East, Martin Elshout and Mark Price.
Each and every boat on their way on the Sabine River, it's going to take 5 bass. My guess is going to be close to 15 pounds the first day to lead this thing.
Almost 200 boats started this morning in the basin, and we're just about finished with the final flight. I got to tell you, Jeff Welch spouting out the rules, making sure everything's in place for safety. And then you got Chad Potts at the other end of the dock. He's calling the numbers. We're about to wrap this thing up. 3 o'clock this afternoon, we'll start the day one weigh-in. Jeff, we got to talk about this new length limit. The 14-inch size limit on the Sabine River. What? A change back in September. Jeff, tell us about it.
September 1st, down here in Sabine, went to 12 inches. It's going to make a bunch of changes in strategy. Previously down here, you had to run a long way to guarantee that you had a 5-fish, 14-inch limit. Now, I think the strategy changes. You stay close, grind out a couple K keepers.
Yeah.
12-inch, 13-inch, throw a couple three-pounders in there, spend your day fishing instead of running.
And some guys are running two and a half hours?
We're going to have guys that are going to burn 1 gallon of gas, and we're going to have guys that are going to burn every bit of gas they have. But, yeah, the place is full of bass. The problem's always been it's full of 12 to 13-and-a-half-inch fish. They're fat. But not real long.
Sure. All right, total weight for day one, what's your guess to be leading?
The leader today will have over 17 pounds.
What?
Yeah, they're here.
17 pounds.
I'm going to say 17, 40th, last place check, 9 pounds.
Wow.
Good fishing.
It is good fishing. We'll see.
Eat, sleep, fish, a motto all Skeeter owners live by. With 16 consecutive NMMA CSI Consumer Satisfaction Awards, our competition doesn't even come close. Join the Skeeter family and be a part of the Skeeter Owners Tournament June 8th through 11th on Lake Fort, Texas. Fun for the whole family. Visit Skeeter.com or see your local dealer for details. Skeeter, number one for so many reasons.
The ultimate predator has evolved again. Now, Yamaha VMAX SHO Performance is prowling the waters in four hungry, exciting new models. With their four valves per cylinder and double overhead cam fuel-injected design, these advanced four-stroke predators are taking performance to a whole new level. Vicious, lean, efficient. VMAX SHO. The pack is growing.
Neither rain nor snow, nor waking up before the roosters. Or the mad rush of planting time. Nor El Nino himself shall stay me and my tractor from bringing up the fruits of this land.
You probably know it's important to keep your car's engine clean, but what about this one? Or this one, or even this one. The fact is carbon deposits can form even in smaller gasoline engines, but Tecron Concentrate Plus Complete Fuel System Cleaner will clean those deposits right up. Tecron's unique formula bonds with and breaks apart carbon deposits more effectively than other fuel additives. So you don't have to worry about whether the engine's gonna work when you're ready to play. Tecron, expect more.
Welcome to the Skeeter Bass Champs television series. Everyone, we are ready for the championship event. We're in Orange, Texas on the Sabine River. A lot of prizes will be given away, over $200,000 for a two-day event on the Sabine River. Get ready! Here we go. The weigh-in for the first day of competition is underway. Our first angler is checking in right now. It's 3 o'clock straight up. We're going to watch.
All right, Dan Ross coming up. Fish with Kate Clifton, they do have a limit. 568. All right, well, a limit is a good start. Scott Holyfield up next, fishing with Craig Massey. Good bag, 11-17. You got a place to go to mark? Can you catch him again there?
I hope so.
Did y'all end up leaving some fish, or did you stay right there and catch him all day?
All day.
All right, good move. There's some strategy in that.
Congratulations, you've got the lead right now.
Thank you.
How'd it feel?
Pretty good.
It's a brand new Skeeter FX 20 on the line.
Still got a lot of people to come in.
All right, gonna weigh one for Big Bass. Needs to be bigger than a 398 to take the lead on day one, Big Bass. Rusty Clark and Corey Rambo up next. Looking for a 398 or bigger. There you go. 466 on the weight for Big Bass. Need 1192 to take the lead. 1103. That's all right. You're well in the top five right now, actually in third place. You can catch them again tomorrow. Kay Durio and Jonathan Simon. They're going to weigh one for Big Bass. I need to be bigger than a 466. Got it, 474. New leader on Big Bass. All right, looking for 1193 to take the lead. Got it, 1363. Let's hold up a few of those fish for pictures. Day one leaders so far.
Day one leaders with 1363. Huge bag, but it's early.
It is. It's a two-day deal. You could, like we was talking about all day, you can't win it the first day, but you can definitely lose it the first day. You know, 1363, we were shooting for 14, yeah, hoping for 15, but we'll take 1363 any day on this water.
Do you think I'm going to see a 15, 16, even a 17-pound bag today?
Probably not.
Really?
It's very tough. The north wind started blowing through, water's dropping, things are changing. People are having to change back up, trying to figure stuff out on the go. And it's going to be tough.
All right, we'll watch and see how they hold.
958, put you well inside the money. You going to be able to go back to the same place tomorrow and catch some?
We will. We caught about 150 today.
150 fish?
Yeah. We've done that for the last 4 days.
Just having to cull a lot?
We have. A lot of them small.
All right, well, sounds like fun. All right, Wendell Ramsey. Need 1363 to take the lead. Should be in the 12-pound range, I would think. I think it'll be closer to 13 even. There you go, 1310. You know how to do this. They've won before down in LBJ, I believe they won.
Second place team right now. Guys, congratulations.
Thank you. We're happy with what we had. We kind of got surprised with a good 4-pounder, helped us a bunch.
Give me a little details on that 4-pounder. Who caught him?
Well, Dad caught the 4-pounder, but there was fish jumping in the boat all day long, and we were swapping turns, but he did catch the 4-pounder. He got me beat today.
What kind of distance did you guys travel today?
We made a 45-minute run down south, so it was a pretty good run for us. You know, everything held together, boat held up, that skeeter ran fine, so we had no problem.
You're on the winning fish. Is that accurate?
I'd like to think so. We caught some good ones today. If they can follow up again tomorrow, we sure could be.
Guys, congratulations. Good luck tomorrow.
Thank you.
There you go. You could be seeing your winners of that Skeeter FX20 for the first place prize this weekend. As you can see, day one is complete. But I can tell you who's nervous right now going in to the second round of competition, our day one leaders. Durio and Simon with 1363. Now remember, it all boiled down to that one big bite of 474. This boat right here is the FX20 prize boat for first place. You'll see that awarded along with that ZX225 for second here at the championship event on the Sabine River. Guys, don't go away when we come back. Day two weigh-in, it's just around the corner.
Hey, who doesn't want to spend less on fuel costs? Well, with the new Delo 10W30 SynBlend diesel oil, it's going to give you better fuel economy as well as great engine protection. Whether you drive a diesel pickup, a big rig, or anything in between, Delo's got you covered.
Versatile fishing machine on earth, unparalleled resolution and clarity. HDS Carbon takes rapid response performance and screen technology to an all-new level. Maximized power, maximized visibility. See Structure Scan 3D, new live network sonar, and more mapping options, all at the same time and faster than ever before. Get up to $300 cash back with the HDS Ultimate Upgrade. Visit Lowrance.com for details.
Hey guys, I want to tell you about a brand new program, the Sportsman's Auto Network. And if you're planning on buying a vehicle this year, you've got to check it out. The Sportsman's Auto Network is a bonus program from the best dealers in Texas, and it offers tons of cash and incentives for all brands of vehicles, new or used. And if you're an outdoorsman who loves to hunt or fish, you'll be eligible for over $30,000 in bonuses just by buying from one of the dealers. The Sportsman's Auto Network.com.
Fishing is a passion. It is a sport like no other. A combination of determination, the right tools, and time on the water. A dedication like no other. At Fun & Sun Boat Sales, we're dedicated to your on-the-water experience. So when you're in the moment, nothing will get in the way. But in some boat sales, two convenient locations. Look for our new tournament support trailer at local bass tournaments. Fun and Sun Boat Sales, supporting our local anglers.
Day one is complete, but I can tell you who's nervous right now going in to the second round of competition, our day one leaders. Durio and Simon with 1363. Now remember, it all boiled down to that one big bite of 474. The second largest bass of the competition and the only other one over 4 pounds was a 470. Day two weigh-in, it's just around the corner.
The time has come. All of the competitors' boats are underway to their first locations of the day.
Ooh, that water's low today.
It's really going to be interesting to see what effects the changing water conditions have on today's leaders. But with over $200,000 on the line, including two fully rigged Skeeter bass boats for first and second place finishing teams, the tension couldn't be higher on the Sabine River.
When this water starts, this current starts to move with this tide, we'll start seeing a lot of shad. They'll start schooling in here, and that's when the activity got really good. Them bass started feeding when those shad started moving. You'll see big balls of shad. When they start moving, we'll start catching fish. Done. Good one. Yes. That's a keeper. Good job. Good job. Good job. Good job. Yes. That's a keeper. Good one. Good.
Team Ramsey is closing in on a limit early in the day. Their strategy? Spinner baits and soft plastics in the bayous around the cypress trees. And fishing approximately 70 miles to the east, Team Durio and Simon continue hitting the more open water locations along the pipelines.
Hey, where'd you go?
Huh?
Yeah. He'd probably go 12, though. I hate to, you know, normally we could pull through here and get 7 or 8 bites. I mean, we should get a limit right here, but it's just, you know, the water's just changing every day. It's not that we're running out of fish, because we only caught 1 3-pounder here yesterday, and we should be catching 7 or 8, like in practice. Couldn't get it extended.
3 in a live well, 1 that we need, 2 squeakers. Hopefully we can get them out. I mean, we start putting 12 inches and 13 inches in a live well, that's not good. We're just running a gun, and we knew it was gonna be a tough day. I mean, we said that from the beginning. Post front, water's falling again, dirty. But you know, when the sun gets up, we're gonna change it. We hit some trees, and I think we can probably put together something decent there, I hope. We're just kind of running our morning deal. That's normally we can catch 10 or 12 keepers, and it's not happening today.
Coming this season on the Skeeter Bass Champs television show, get ready for our brand new competition elimination format, pitting event winners and Angler of the Year teams against one another. Watch as our 4 divisional Angler of the Year teams, along with 5 Bass Champs event winners, go head to head as they put it all on the line with just one goal in mind, to become the Bass Champs TV Challenge Champion.
Yes!
Hi, I'm Randy White, General Manager of Taylor Oil Company. We've been servicing the Metroplex for over 60 years with quality Chevron products and dependable service. But don't take my word for it, take the word of one of my customers.
I'm Dustin Bennett, I own First Response Fleet Service. We repair and maintain multiple fleet counts. We rely on Taylor Oil products to service our trucks.
At Taylor Oil Company, our number one goal is customer service. Whether you're just changing your oil at your house or you have 1,000 pieces of equipment, we can take care of you.
Taylor Oil Company. Call or visit online today.
Eat, Sleep, Fish, a motto all Skeeter owners live by, with 16 consecutive NMMA CSI Consumer Satisfaction Awards. Our competition doesn't even come close. Join the Skeeter family and be a part of the Skeeter Owners Tournament June 8th through 11th on Lake Fort, Texas. Fun for the whole family. Visit Skeeter.com or see your local dealer for details. Skeeter, number one for so many reasons.
The ultimate predator has evolved again. Now, Yamaha VMAX SHO Performance is prowling the waters in four hungry, exciting new models. With their four valves per cylinder and double overhead cam fuel-injected design, these advanced four-stroke predators are taking performance to a whole new level. Vicious, lean, efficient. VMAX SHO. The pack is growing.
Hey guys, I want to tell you about a brand new program, the Sportsman's Auto Network. And if you're planning on buying a vehicle this year, you've got to check it out. The Sportsman's Auto Network is a bonus program from the best dealers in Texas, and it offers tons of cash and incentives for all brands of vehicles, new or used. And if you're an outdoorsman who loves to hunt or fish, you'll be eligible for over $30,000 in bonuses just by buying from one of the dealers. The SportsmansAutoNetwork.com. Skeeter Bass Champs with Fish Fishburne is brought to you by Skeeter, eat, sleep, fish. Yamaha, reliability starts here. Techron, expect more. Power Pole, swift, silent, secure. Lowrance, find, navigate, dominate. Berkeley, catch more fish. Sportsman's Auto Network, dealers that speak our language. Chevron Dello, let's go further. It's day two of the Skeeter Bass Champs Championship event in Orange, Texas on the Sabine River.
I mean, we start putting 12 inchers and 13 inchers in a live well, that's not good. We're not the only ones. Everybody's losing water, everybody's water's getting dirty.
And for a change-up, we've placed cameras in the boats of the first and second place team from day one. And so far, Team Durio and Simon aren't feeling so good about holding their first place lead.
Hey, that's a keeper, huh? Probably not. Probably not. You gotta be kidding me. 12 and a smidget.
Yeah.
Wow. We got 6 pounds.
70 miles away, the father and son duo of Team Ramsey are catching a lot of fish, and they're feeling great about the way their day's been going so far.
Good job, Wendell. That'll cull that little scrawny one. Got him? This is a sweet spot. Caught a lot of nice fish in this area, and they're just moving up on this point. You got two creeks that come together, and just everything's funneling in here. It's just a timing. It's all about timing, I think. So, you know, we're committed. We're not leaving it. I know we can win the tournament right here if they'll just eat for us. They're here. And these are fresh fish. They're just moving up. Gorging on these shad. You know, we're not out of the run, even though we don't have a real big stream because of this cold front. I think the cold front's gonna make it tough fishing for everybody. So every little ounce counts. I don't care if you got 7 pounds or 10 pounds. Every one of them's gonna go a long way. Like, I think that'll cull right there.
Little fella's going back.
Get him. Good job, Wendell. Let me take care of that one for you.
Go ahead. Here's that in a minute.
We are going to put a cull tag on you, buddy. We caught some fish. I think the front hurt the quality fish for us, so we got a limit. We'll take our chances to the weigh-in, see what happens. That's all we can do now.
Could be your new leaders right here. You need 1173. You have 1193. So that bumps you up into the lead right now. Good work, guys.
Lance Cole, it's early in the weigh-in, but you currently have the lead. How's it feel?
Man, we were really excited. We found some good fish early on during practice time. We knew we'd go get them, so that's what we did. We gambled a lot. We made a long run, but it paid off.
Kay Durio, Jonathan Simon. You need 901 to take the lead. 799 on the weight is not going to be enough to put you in the lead, but a solid performance for you guys.
We just didn't get the bites today. I mean, that's just a
day one leaders, I know you're frustrated and disappointed.
You know, frustration, yeah, disappointed. I mean, that's fishing, you know, and we just lost all our water. We lost almost 2 foot of water in 2 days, and I felt like we was on a Red River again.
Nothing was working today. Like Jonathan just said, we lost 2 foot of water. When you lose that much water on a river system, it's tough to find out where these fish go. So they go into a different pattern that only God knows where they hide.
Well, guys, you are great competitors. Thank you. I know you slid just a little bit. You're still in the top five currently, and you have a beautiful family.
Thank you, man. Thank you.
All right, we'll watch.
All right, these guys were in second place going into today. Wendell Ramsey Jr. and Wendell Ramsey Sr. You need 882 to take the lead right now. We did have a camera with them all day long. You need 882. You got 954. New leaders right here. Hold your fish up real quick for some pictures.
Gentlemen, there's less than 10 seconds remaining. This could be first and second place. That's it. It's official. Your son will be here in just a minute.
Yeah, just a minute. He's taking a polygraph. I know he's sweating bullets right now. It's about time he needed. He needed a polygraph.
Congratulations. Second place, a brand new Skeeter ZX 225 for you guys. And, of course, the 20 FX, bam, from Skeeter Boats and Yamaha. Guys, congrats.
It's time now for the Berkeley winning strategy. After studying the Sabine River's fishing history and putting in several days of practice, Team Ramsey relied on several different areas to obtain their victory, one of which was near Pine Island Bayou called Cook's Lake. And by fishing in the Neches River, they found large schools of bait fish that supported a healthy bass population. The key was to cover as much of the deeply stained water as possible by casting a half-ounce double willow leaf spinnerbait with nickel blades and a chartreuse and white skirt to the base of cypress trees. As a cold front passed through the area on day one, they were forced to rely on a much slower presentation in the second round of competition. And by flipping and pitching Texas Rig soft plastic lures, they were able to catch those inactive fish. And that's your Berkeley winning strategy.
Well, there you go, our champions for this week from Orange, Texas on the Sabine River. I'm your host, Fish Fishburne. Join us next week for more Skeeter Bass Champs Television.